I've got some roses here that we're going to give, but the organization, we are celebrating 75 years out from World War II, and it's called Never Forget the Spirit of 45. You can get on the internet, and we're planting rose gardens all over the United States with Rosie the Riveter roses. And so we're going to plant two here today. They won't stay here. They're going to go over there in close to our monument when it goes up. But we're going to temporarily plant them here today in honor of the Rosies. And like I say, there's going to be rose gardens, and there is rose gardens all over the United States. And we've already planted one in memory of our founder here in Sun City, who was Happy Sargol, and she passed a year ago. But there was almost 300 people at her funeral, and she was almost 94. So that she was just a tremendous part of our group, and she is very much missed in our group. And we planted one at the Sun Bowl. I don't know if you're familiar with the Sun City area, but we have an open air theater where they have free concerts. I think it holds 7,000, but they have a huge rose garden. And we planted a rose in her memory in March, and that would have been a year since she passed. But we really appreciate the exposure of the Rosies. The Rosies, there were, wrap your head around this, 6 million. 6 million of these women that stepped up to the plate, and they filled the men's jobs. They changed factories that were making farm equipment, anything else, and they changed them into making airplanes and tanks. And out in California, there was a lot of ships and also aircraft. Fran, would you like to come up and just say one little bit about what you did?
Well, I guess.
Yeah, tell them where you served.
I worked in actually Georgetown, but it's a little suburb of Seattle, Washington, 5 minutes over to their plant. And we were under contract to Boeing, so we worked on the P-38s, and they were fighter planes, what we made. So I worked in the bulkheads. The bulkheads were all the instruments go in there, in any airplane. That's called a bulkhead. And so it's quite interesting. I bucked most of the time, and a couple of weeks I riveted. And all they think is I riveted, but I didn't. I bucked too.
Some of you don't know what bucking is.
It takes a little muscles.
I didn't get them out of my van, but I have the bucker and the riveter, and we can pass it around and you can see what it is.
It's a fun thing. Us girls were only 17, you know, and working and having fun. I'll tell you something you don't know. The whole United States was together. I don't care who the president would have been or who he was, but when all this started, of course, it was President Roosevelt and then President Truman from him. And they were for him even the Republicans, even though he was a Democrat. I'm serious, guys. We were all together. It didn't matter. And not like this bull crap we get today. It's sad.
You bet.
That's all I can say. Yeah, thank you.